us direction from above. We need a word.
Answer Father's life. So yeah, we all have a calling of priest up on our life, whether we choose to walk in it or not.
Yes.
We're all called to declare the words and the word of God to everyone we meet. We're to take God's word out of here and take it to a dying world.
Yeah.
That's what we're called to do. We don't understand. We want to come up with all these different ministries. But the Bible teaches us, Paul said, we've been given the ministry of reconciliation.
Yeah.
We're called to do one thing.
Yeah.
Take a loving God to a dying world.
Yeah.
And bring them back to Jesus.
Wow.
We allowed him to work through us. That's the calling for the church.
Yeah.
Every other ministry, we've added things to it. But our ministry is this, reconciling a dying world.
Yeah.
So that's what we're called.
Come on now.
Not coming here. And I'm not preaching against coming to church, because we need to come in here.
Yeah.
Iron sharpens iron. We need to come in here and get prepared, battle dressed, to go out and fight.
Yeah.
But once we get here, we can't just stay together.
Yeah.
We got to get out of here, because the work is done outside these
doors. Right.
This is preaching and teaching and singing and ushering, all of that. That's church work.
Yeah.
But the work of the church is reconciling the world.
Yeah.
We need to be about the work
of
the church.
Now.
Not so much about church work. We're all caught
come
up in what position can I hold?
Yeah.
Can I be over this program? Can
come
I be over
now.
That program? It's not about how many programs we have.
Yeah.
You see back when in the Good Samaritan, the high priest went on to the other side of the road. Rather than, because he had on his way to Wednesday night service. the Levi. He went on the other side of the road because he didn't want to be late for Sunday school.
All right.
But God is more concerned with people, with souls, than he is about service. God wants us to be out there trying to get somebody that don't know him to come in here and learn about him. That's what we're called to do as a church. God rebuked the leaders of Israel because they were comfortable where they were. They were more concerned about themselves. They were concerned about theirs. You know, that we don't see that happening in the church today, do we? Me and mine is okay, so I know you may have a struggle at your house. My kid's doing great. So, I mean, you know, I'm going to pray for you if I find time, if I think about it. But the Bible tells me that we ought to bear one another's burdens.
Yeah.
You know, I shouldn't pray without praying for you.
All right.
Samuel asked him, when they told Samuel to pray for him, he said, why should I sin against God by not praying for you?
Mm.
We're called to intercede one for another.
Yeah.
We're called to lift one another up before God.
Yeah.
If you're sick, then I should feed it. If we're many members, one body,
right.
Whatever pain you have, I should have.
Yep.
Because we're one body.
Yeah.
Whatever you're struggling with, this should be my struggle.
Yeah.
I need to be standing before God as a priest.
Mm-hmm.
I need to be standing before God on your behalf at all times. Not when I feel like it, but at all times. We have to bear one another up. That's what we're called to do. He was rebuking them because they were... Not only were they in their comfort zone, but they weren't concerned. They were hard-hearted. They were callous. He didn't say that they actually scattered the sheep, but he said that they were going scattered and they wasn't concerned. They wasn't searching for them. They wasn't looking for them. They out there. They just out there.
All right.
I got it.
Woo.
They get it the best way they can. Is that going on in the church today? Because somebody needs to hear it. Somebody's walking around hopeless today, and they need to hear that there's hope in Jesus.
But if
we don't take them, Jesus, where are they going to hear it from? Paul said we're written living epistles, read of all men.
Right.
So we need to make sure that we know what God has called us to do, what our responsibility is. And because of their unwillingness, he didn't say that they scattered, but they were guilty of scattering because they refused together. So we're in the same place today.
Yes, sir.
We're guilty of scattering because we refuse to go together. Now my text is coming from Matthew 30, verse 12. Now, the NIV says that if you're not scattering, gathering with me, you're scattering. If you're not with me, you're against me. If you're not gathering with me, it's scattering.
Yes.
If we're not helping Jesus to draw out of the world, we're scattering.
Well.
So we understand that there's a group of people that have not made a decision yet. if they're going to be on the Lord's side or not. Mm-hmm. We know that. We know everybody's not saved, trying to live saved or whatever. We understand that. But we know that the Bible was written to blood-bought believers.
Yes,
that's right. So we also know that the word that's coming forth out of this Bible was written to the church.
Yeah.
And we understand that each of us make up the church.
Yes.
That we're all the church, not this building, but we're all the church. We all make up for the church. So the question posed to the church today, I would like you to look at your neighbor and I and ask them this question. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Gathering.
Gathering.
Or scattering.
Scattering.
How you living?
How you living?
Gathering or scattering? How you living? See, it's not about the word that we speak. It's about the life that we live.
All right.
It's not about how holy I am to you in here. It's how am I living up in my workplace. How am I living up and down the streets of this community. How am I living at school or wherever. It's not about what I say. Because nobody really wants to hear what
I
say. They want to know what I'm doing. They see how I'm interacting with them. They see how I'm treating them. They see if God loves, why am I not loving? If I'm supposed to be Christ-like, why am I not loving the way God loves? They want to see that from me. And if not, they don't hear a word I have to say until they see me living what I proclaim to them. That's what we need to be found doing. Living. Christ-like, yes. Rather than talking. Christ, I mean, anybody can talk it.
Yeah.
You don't have to be holy to speak all the word.
Yeah.
You have to be working to live the word.
Yeah.
Because it's a lot easier to talk it than it is to live it.
Yeah.
Ask anybody that's trying to live it. You may have to even search for that individual. But if you're trying to live it, it's work.
Yeah,
it's work because you have so many things coming against you that try to prevent you. The enemy doesn't care how much you talk, as long as you're living like hell.
Yeah.
He don't care what you have to say, as long as you're not trying to live the word you're speaking. The enemy does not care. What he wants to do is bring obstacles before us to keep us from living what we're speaking. Because everyone is looking at what we're doing. Everyone is witnessing how we're living, how we call ourselves Christians, but if we're living other than like Christians, then they see that. And again, now the church is labeled a bunch of hypocrites. It may be one. But that one get a whole church of
them.
We all need to, at some point, get to a place. And we all, the Bible says we all fall short. We all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We all miss it on a daily basis. Because the Bible teaches that the thoughts of wickedness is sin. We all miss it on a daily basis. But we strive on a daily basis to get closer to maturity, to get closer to perfection. Our goal is to attain, that Paul said. We press toward that mark. We realize we're not there yet, but our goal is to get there. So with every passing day, we're trying harder to be more Christ-like than we were the day before. Now he's scattering. Let me explain something. I said, how you living? My wife said in Norman that I sound a little creamy.
Creamy?
What?
Creamy.
Well,
you
creamy.
Know, she said, well, could I be saying gathering and scattering? So, she said I sound a little creamy, but I know I know all y'all from the corner, you know.
Yeah.
Y'all, I just asked you, gathering and scattering. I didn't put a G on anything, but you know what I'm talking about. I can talk to y'all.
Yeah.
So the question is still, how you living?
You all right.
Okay, now we know scattering. What is scattering? Scattering is anything we're doing to drive people away from Jesus. Whether it's our words, our actions, or our attitude. Now, my words may be all right. My action may be all right. But how is my attitude? You know, it's my mind stuck out when I do it. People notice that. When I hug you and tell you that I love you, you don't feel nothing. People notice that.
Come on now.
You know, when I call myself giving you rebuke, but you don't feel no love. You don't see no me.
On the calm, on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.